On behalf of the Majority Caucus, we too want to offer a few comments. But first of all, to the family and friends, especially the granddaughter, we are so glad you could be here today to help us honor your grandfather and a great leader here in our General Assembly. Mr. Speaker, we do stand to celebrate the 45th anniversary of this historic election of Speaker K. Leroy Irvis, and as the 130th Speaker of the Pennsylvania House of Representatives. It's hard to believe there are that many. It's only appropriate that we are here to honor one of our own as we do get into the Memorial Day holiday, a reminder of those who go before us. Speaker's life was a hallmark by breaking barriers and achieving many great outstanding achievements. We all know that Speaker Irvis, for historic election as the first Black Speaker of the House, as mentioned before, but his life and his story go much deeper than that. Speaker Irvis originally, oriented from the Hudson Valley of New York State, was the second Black person to graduate from sunny Albany, graduating with a master's degree in education. In his career, as we heard earlier, he was a labor leader and an entrepreneur before deciding to go to law school at the University of Pittsburgh. Later, he was hired as the first Black district attorney in Allegheny County District Attorney's Office. In nearly a 30-year career here in Pennsylvania, as we heard, he got 250 bills signed into law, but he also sponsored well over 875. He is credited with passing legislation creating a Pennsylvania Human Relations Commission, as my colleague acknowledged, the Pennsylvania Higher Education Assistance and Equal Opportunity Program. He was a champion of Pennsylvania's community colleges, which we know are so vital for our communities, and worked to increase the transparency of General Assembly and that of lobbyists. He was a member of the House Democratic leadership for a total of 26 years out of his 30. And as we know, he served for Speaker nearly 8 years, being elected two different times. After leaving the Speaker's office, Speaker Irvis showed he was a man of many talents, publishing a book of poetry. Something which I shared passion with Speaker Irvis was his woodworking and enjoyment of spending time in creating things. Although he was a sculptor, some would say I'm a wood hack. But nonetheless, to appreciate these God-given commodities and to manufacture or create something with our hands. More than anything, when I look at the life of and the work of Speaker Leroy Irvis, I see a man who was immensely passionate about the work that we do here and respect for this institution. Work we saw and what we should see as being wholly good for all people of Pennsylvania. In his farewell address, Speaker Irvis called our form of government the most remarkable invention of mankind. Let's hold ourselves to that standard, honor this good man, great servant, and public leader as we stand here today and also tomorrow. Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and thank you again to the family for allowing us to honor this great fellow.